Min klare overbevisning er, at selvfølgelig er det et overgreb. Men hvis man ikke mener, at det er et overgreb, så kan man jo diskutere det her fra nu af, og jeg ved ikke, hvor lang tid.
It's wrong to take a sharp blade and to cut, to dismember, to mutilate that is doing by rape.
This is a rape.
This is the greatest violation of human rights.
I think you're right. What is that circumcision?
Well, I said, you know what? It's a surgery that he's not consenting to. So later on, if he wants to do it, let's do it.
You're right.
I said, I respect it. You know, with the Jewish community, I get it. And part of the faith, cool.
Right, right.
But, you know, it's
what's
like,
the point? I agree with you. I mean, you mean okay, to tell me
right.
Somewhere it's right to cut off skin on your penis? I mean, you know that's a man-made myth.
Right. You know, well, actually, Carl Kellogg, back in the day, who was a Puritan, thought that it would be more sanitary, and it became sort of this, it took on a
life. It's a mutilation.
It's a mutilation, and then it's a big business for doctors now.
Circumcision results in long-term symptoms that fit the pattern of post-traumatic stress disorder, such as avoidance of feelings and stimuli related to the trauma, reduced emotional response, and for some, a tendency to anger.
I think the first time that I really felt angry that I was circumcised was when I was about 16, and I went to some family wedding, and my parents pointed out the moyle who circumcised me, and I felt really, really angry.
If I could speak directly to the moyle who botched my circumcision, I would say, how can you fathom removing the blood from an infant with your mouth? How do you justify that in your mind? Is that the best way to do things? How did that practice come about? Is that something that, you know, I mean, is that a joke? Or is that really what goes down? I mean, I understand that there is a need to keep the area clean, but does it please you? What was your first, you know, how did you get into that? Like, you know, how do you practice for that sort of thing? what compels one to go into that practice? Are you getting paid crazy amounts of money? What do you say when you come home to your family at the end of the day? And, you know, how did it go, honey? Well, there was a lot of blood. I sucked most of it away. You know, let's eat.
Grown up, kind of furious about this thing that happened to me. Maybe from about adolescence, when I really first started to understand what had, like, taken place.
I just, like, kept bringing it up. And there were, like, serious arguments, right? Like, so I would have a Sunday dinner with my family. And I would go to Sunday dinner and bring up circumcision. And of course, my Jewish grandma was there, who will never budge on circumcision. And I would bring it up, and my dad would be like, all right, maybe it's time to go.
Jeg vil sige, at det har haft kæmpe konsekvenser for vores familie. Fordi jeg må jo konstatere, at mine forældre har overladt mig til at blive skåret i. Og det er altså ikke sådan, man udøver sin forældregerning.
How much of your genitals now, whether you're circumcised, a man or a woman, how many of your part of your penis or of your vulva can be removed without it affecting sex? I'm probably thinking most of you think, well, if you removed any of this tissue, I would have less sensation. There would be less there. This would be problematic if tissue from my genitals were removed right now. And this doesn't change when you do it to an infant. When you do it to an infant, they just don't know, because they never had the opportunity to have their whole body. And that feeling of not ever having the opportunity to have my whole body makes me feel very, very violated, and I am not alone.
I'm very angry of my parents that cut my penis.
I don't know that I was not born Jewish. I know I was not circumcised until 8 years old. I remember to be in a hospital with my arms on the sides of the bed, taped, so I could not move my arms. I remember to be angry. I had no control over the circumstances in which I became a child. And they robbed me of that. They owe me something.
זה נכון, כן עשיתי תביעת נזיקים נגד ההורים שלי. על העוול ונזק שגרמו לי ההורים שלי באמצעות הברית מילה. פגיעה בכבודי, בכבודי כאנוש וכבן ישראל, כן? כבן כאיש שמאמין באמונה שלמה באלוהי אברהם, יצחק ויעקב.
I am angry about my own circumcision. But that was a long time ago in my mind. But when I think now, 33 years later, that it's still going on, still going on, even though we've landed on the moon and we have computers everywhere and we've gone through such tremendous social upheavals, such tremendous reevaluation of society and our values, that this thing is still stuck in our practices. That makes me angrier.
Do you know what happened when I finally built up the courage to confront my Jewish father about carving his psychotic and demonstrably evil ideology into my body, raping me of one of the most fundamental acts of connection with another human being for life? Do you know what he said to me? My Jewish father looked me dead in the eye, dead in the face, straight in the eye, and what he said, I will never forget. And he said, "You're wrong." I'm wrong? I'm wrong? I may be many things, but I'm so far from fucking wrong! And I will tear our covenant to pieces to prove it! Do you feel my rage? Do you? Let me validate yours, because it is fucking real, it is fucking justified, and you can draw a straight line back to the fucking rabbis to prove it! Well, now? Now? It is time for me to issue a commandment of my own. And that is this. We cannot and we will not tolerate Judaism in its current form. We are done tolerating cults that ritually mutilate their children's genitals.